At home. 1. Where is Jane?
She is in the living room.
What is she doing?
She is playing the piano.
Where is the car?
It is in the garage.
Where is the dog?
The dog is in front of the door.
What is the dog doing?
The dog is eating.
At home, 2. Where are you?
I am in the kitchen.
What are you doing?
I am cooking dinner.
Where are Bill and Mary?
They are in the living room.
What are they doing?
They are watching TV.
Where is the cat?
She is in the dining room.
What is she doing?
She is sleeping.
My favorite photographs. 1.
Who is she?
She is my sister.
What's her name?
Her name is Jennifer.
Where is she in this photograph?
She's in Toronto.
What is that building behind her?
She's standing in front of the CN Tower. Location. 1. Where is the school?
It's between the library and the park.
Where is the post office?
It's across from the movie theater.
Where is the Royal Bank?
It's next to the supermarket.
Where is the gas station?
It's around the corner from the church.
Where is the barber shop?
It's near the bus station.
Location 2. Excuse me, can you tell me the way to the nearest bank?
Yes, it's on Geneva Street. As a matter of fact, I'm going that way myself. So if you come with me, I will show you.
Thanks very much.
You're welcome.
Color 1. May I help you?
Yes, please. I am looking for an umbrella.
What's your favorite color?
It's black.
Sorry, we have no black umbrellas right now. Here is a nice umbrella.
But this umbrella is yellow.
That's okay. Yellow umbrellas are very popular this year. Color 2. Excuse me, is this your umbrella?
No, it isn't.
Are you sure?
Yes, I am sure. That umbrella is brown, and my umbrella is yellow.
Video designed by English7Levels.com.
No questions. Are you married?
No, I'm not. I'm single.
Tell me about your new car. Is it large?
No, it's not. It is small.
Tell me about the questions in your English book. Are they difficult?
No, they're not. They are easy.
Tell me about your new neighbors. Are they quiet?
No, they aren't. They are noisy.
Short answer.
Is Alice young or old?
She is young.
Is Bill tall or short?
He is short.
Is Albert's apartment big or little?
It's small.
Were the last examinations easy or difficult?
They were difficult.
Is Julie married or single?
She is single.
Telephone call 2.
Hello, Jack. This is Dave. I want to return the book I borrowed from you last night. Will you be home at about 6 o'clock?
Yes, I will. I'll be cooking dinner.
Oh, well, then I won't come over at 6.
Why not?
I don't want to disturb you.
Don't worry. You won't disturb me.
Okay. I'll see you at 6.
What's a grant?
My daughter is going to college.
That's great, but it must be expensive.
Yes, but she has a grant.
A grant? What's a grant?
The government is giving her money.
To pay for her education?
That's right.
Does it pay for everything?
No, she has a loan too.
What's the difference between a loan and a grant?
You have to pay back a loan. A grant is a gift.
I'm busy on Friday.
Would you like to go to a pop concert?
Well, I'd like to, but when is it?
On Friday evening.
What a pity. I'm busy on Friday.
Maybe you could change your plans? It's going to be a really great concert.
Maybe I will. I wouldn't want to miss it.
Great. I'll see you Friday.
Bless you.
Achoo!
God bless you.
Thank you.
You have a cold?
Yes, that's why I'm sneezing so much.
I hope you feel better soon.
I get a bad cold every winter.
Are you taking anything for your cold?
I'm taking Contact.
Does it help?
Yes, but it makes me sleepy.
You'd better not drive then. I don't feel well.
What are you looking for?
My jacket. I'm going to the doctor.
Why? What's the problem?
I'm not sure, but I don't feel well.
Do you have a fever?
No, but I have a pain in my chest.
What time is your appointment?
11:30. I'm going now. Bye.
Goodbye. I hope it's nothing serious.
Thanks. See ya. Can you help me?
Can you help me, officer?
I'll try. What's the problem?
I can't get into my car.
Where are your keys?
They're in the car.
Don't worry. I can open it.
How can you do that?
With a coat hanger. It's easy.
Where can we get a coat hanger?
There's one in the police car. Wait here.
Thanks a lot. You're very kind.
Taking a cab.
Hello.
Hello.
Where do you want to go?
70 Maple Street, please.
70 Mibble Street?
No, Maple Street.
Maple Street. Let's see. Is that near St. David Street?
I don't know. I've only been here 1 week.
Oh, where are you from?
Toronto. I hate to get up.
I hate to get up in the morning.
Me too. What time do you get up?
At 6 o'clock.
Why do you get up so early?
I have to be at work by 7.
I don't get up until 8.
You're lucky. What do you do?
I own a bookstore.
What time does your store open?
At 8:30. A hot day.
This heat is killing me.
Me too. It must be 95 degrees.
I would like a cold drink.
I'll get you one.
Thanks. Mmm, this tastes good.
It does. Jeez, this hot weather makes me lazy.
Me too. Get me another drink?
I guess if you're lazy, no one else is allowed to be.
Thanks for understanding.
Phone out of order, 1.
Hey, hey!
What's wrong?
There's something wrong with the phone. I'm getting a strange noise.
Are you? I can hear you clearly.
Hello? Hello?
This payphone might be out of order. I'll call you again with another phone.
Hello? How about now? Is there still a strange noise?
Yes. Perhaps my phone is out of order.
You should get in touch with the phone company.
Phone out of order, 2.
Hey, what's the matter with the phone? Here, listen to this peculiar noise.
It doesn't sound like a dial tone.
It must be out of order. We'd better notify the phone company.
How do we do that? We can't use the phone.
Let's go next door and use our neighbor's phone.
He's always complaining about people. I don't want to ask any favors of him.
How about across the street?
I forgot about Mrs. Riley. I'm sure she'd let us use her phone. Getting a visa.
Does it take long to get a visa?
It depends on the season. Anywhere from 1 month to 2 months.
What do I need to do?
Fill out an application form and wait.
Will there be a long waiting period?
Not if you don't run into any government delays. Employing a new member.
Well, this woman may be suitable for the job, but is she energetic enough?
Yes, she certainly seems to have lots of energy.
She's got to be ambitious, too. Is she?
Yes, she has plenty of ambition.
And we really need a flexible sort of person. Do you think she is?
She seems to be determined enough, but she's a little tough.
Well, I guess we'll give her a try and see how she works out.
Video designed by English7Levels.com.
A date.
What are you so happy about? You're grinning from ear to ear.
Sandy and I are going to go out this weekend.
Oh, yeah? That's fast work. That's great. Which night are you going to see her? Friday or Saturday?
On Friday. She isn't going to be in town on Saturday and Sunday. She's going to visit a friend in Quebec.
What are you going to do on Friday?
I don't know yet. Do you have any ideas?
How about taking her to a Chinese restaurant? I've heard that she likes Chinese food.
That's a great idea.
What are you going to wear on your date?
I'm going to wear my new suit.
That's too formal. Wear your jeans and a t-shirt.
How about your sports jacket? Are you going to wear it on Friday night?
No, I am not. Go ahead and wear it.
What did you do yesterday?
Hi, how are you? You look tired. Did you sleep okay last night?
No, I didn't.
Why? What did you do yesterday?
I went to a nightclub last night and danced all night.
Oh, yeah? Did you have a good time?
I had a wonderful time, but I'm beat today.
What time did you leave the nightclub?
I left at about 3 a.m.
I'm not surprised that you're tired. Which nightclub did you go to?
Fantastic. It's on Ontario Street. It's really nice. Traveling by air.
Do I check in here for Air Canada to Mexico?
Do you already have your ticket?
Yes. Here you are.
Thank you. Can you put your luggage up here, please?
Sure. I have 3 suitcases.
We allow only 2 pieces. You'll have to pay an extra charge.
Oh. Can I carry this one with me?
No, I'm sorry. It won't fit under your seat. That's $45.
Here you are.
Thank you. You can choose your seat. A window seat or aisle seat?
I'd like a window seat, please.
Fine. Seat 15A. Here's your ticket and your boarding pass. Enjoy your flight. At the customs.
Good morning. Can I see your passport?
Certainly. Here it is.
Yes, that's all right. Have you got anything to declare?
Yes, I have. I've got some whiskey and some cigarettes.
How much whiskey have you got?
A liter.
That's all right. And how many cigarettes have you got?
200.
Fine. What about perfume?
No, I haven't.
Good. Open your case, please.
Pardon?
Open your case, please. Open it now. Oh, dear. Look at this. You've got 3 bottles of whiskey, 400 cigarettes, and a lot of perfume.
Does that mean I can't go? A new baby.
Well, hello, Mr. Wallace. You seem unusually happy today.
I just became a father.
Congratulations. A boy or a girl?
You never saw such a cute girl. 9 pounds, 3 ounces, and as cute as a button.
Doesn't this call for cigars?
Oh, yes. I forgot about the cigars. Here, have one.
Thank you. How's your wife?
She's just fine.
Is English difficult?
Where are you going?
To Canada.
Why are you going there?
I'm going to learn English. There's a school there that has an excellent program.
Is learning English going to be difficult?
Yes, I have to study and practice a lot.
Where is your school?
It's in a town called St. Catharines in Ontario.
I'm jealous. I'll bet you're excited.
Yes, but I'm also really nervous. Washing his car.
Where's Kevin?
He's in front of the house.
What is he doing?
Washing his car.
Not again.
Yes, he takes good care of his car.
But he never cleans his room.
I know, it's always dirty.
And nothing is in order.
You're right, his room is a mess.
Maybe he should move into the car.
At the restaurant.
This is a big menu.
Yeah, what are you getting?
Chicken, peas, and baked potatoes.
I don't know what to get.
They have very good turkey.
I had turkey yesterday.
How about steak?
Perfect. I'll get steak and mashed potatoes.
What vegetable are you getting?
I'm not getting any. I don't like vegetables. When's the baby due?
I have some good news.
What is it?
Lisa is going to have a baby.
That's great. I'm so happy for her.
Me too.
Do they want a boy or a girl?
A girl.
When's the baby due?
In the beginning of September.
I'm going to phone Lisa tonight.
That's nice. Say hello for me.
Bus stop.
Jean.
Barbara, do you work around here?
Yes, I work in that building across the street.
Really? What do you do?
I work in a law office. I'm a secretary.
Oh, that's interesting.
What about you? What do you do?
I work at Durer Restaurant.
Oh, are you a cook?
No, I'm a waitress.
That's a really hard job. I don't envy you.
Me neither. In the bus.
Do you live alone, Jean?
No, I don't. I live with my family. How about you?
I'm married now. I got married last year.
Really? Congratulations. Who did you marry?
His name's Jeff Hunt. He lives in my building.
Oh, what does he do?
He's a doctor.
How wonderful. I'm very happy for you. Gardening.
Your garden is really lovely.
Thank you. I enjoy working in the garden.
Do you do everything yourself?
I trim the bushes and weed the flower beds myself.
Who cuts the grass?
Oh, it's so big that I hire one of the boys in the neighborhood to do it for me.
Well, I must say, he does a good job.
Yes, his work is more than satisfactory. A lazy boy.
I'm very angry with my son, Harry.
Why? What's the problem?
He's not doing well in school.
That's a surprise. Harry's a smart boy.
Yes, but he never studies.
Did you talk to his teachers?
Yes, I did.
What did they say?
He's a nice boy, but he's very lazy.
Maybe they're right.
I'm afraid so.
Have you thought about getting him a tutor?
Maybe that's a good idea. I really want him to excel.
Let's go look in the phone book now, then. Can I drive there?
What time is it?
It's 3:00.
Oh, no. I'm late.
Where are you going?
To the dentist.
Can I drive you there?
Sure, that will help.
Do you have a toothache?
Yes, and it's very bad.
I'm sorry to hear that.
I've had it for weeks, and this is the first time that I could get in. My dentist is always so busy.
I guess that's a good thing. It means a lot of people like him. A new dress.
Who is it?
It's me, dear.
Don't you have your key?
No, let me in. Let's her in.
What's in that box? What did you get?
A new dress, honey.
But you have a closet full of dresses.
I know, but I need a new one.
What's wrong with all the other dresses?
They're not this one. A picnic.
Let's go for a picnic.
That's a great idea. Where shall we go?
Let's go to the park.
How far is it?
About a mile.
Is it a nice place?
Sure. It has picnic tables and a beautiful lake.
Good. I'll make some sandwiches.
I'll bring soda and cookies.
The kids will love it.
Video designed by English7Levels.com.
I'm going skiing.
We've got 10 inches of snow.
Wow, that's terrific.
What's so terrific about it?
I'm going skiing.
Skiing? Are you serious?
Yes, it's a lot of fun.
Maybe, but it's also dangerous.
You need to live on the edge.
And you need to make sure you don't fall off of it.
Traffic rules.
Sarah, you can't park here. It's a bus stop.
Oh, we'll be back in a few minutes. It's okay.
Oh, no, it isn't. You'll get a parking ticket if you leave it here.
No, I won't. It's 5:30. All the traffic wardens have gone home.
Sarah.
Yes?
Is this your car, ma'am?
Housework.
I'm really tired, and now I have to go home and cook.
Do you make dinner every night?
Yes, I usually make dinner, and my husband washes the dishes.
I live alone, so I do everything. Sometimes I eat out, though. There are some good restaurants in my neighborhood.
Where do you live?
Near the Penn Center.
Oh, that's good. There aren't any good restaurants near my house.
Does your husband help you do housework much?
Yes. He sets the table almost every night, and he makes our bed every morning, but I usually make all the meals.
How about cleaning?
We clean the house together every weekend. I vacuum the rooms, and he usually sweeps the floor of the kitchen, and he does yard work.
Your husband helps you so much. Does he help do the laundry, too?
Well, he's never helped me do the laundry.
Oral exams.
Hey, Cindy, have you finished the exam?
Yes, I have. Phew.
Was it hard?
Well, yes, it was hard. Pretty hard.
Did you pass?
I don't know. Mrs. Lester didn't tell me.
What questions did she ask?
First, she asked me what my name was.
Well, that was easy, wasn't it?
Yes, except I couldn't remember. Then she asked me where I came from and how long it took to get here from my country.
And what else did she ask?
She asked how long I'd been studying English here in Canada, and she asked how I would use English in the future.
Yes, yes, go on.
Then she asked me to explain the difference between my country and Canada.
Anything else?
I'm trying to remember. Oh, yes, she asked if I spoke any other language.
Is that all?
Oh, there were a lot of other questions. She asked me what my hobbies were, where I visited in Canada, then I was asked to read a passage.
What did she say at the end?
Let's see. Oh, yes, she asked me to tell you to go in right away. Would you call me?
Well, see you tomorrow.
I'd better go, too. Oh, would you do me a favor?
Sure.
Would you call me tomorrow at 6 o'clock in the morning? Tomorrow's my daughter's birthday. I want to get her a new robe, and I have to pick up the dry cleaning and pick up the cake from the bakery. Anyway, I have lots of things to do, but I'm not sure I can get up early.
Do you need a hand?
Oh, can you? That would be great. Can you go to the mall and buy her a new robe, pick up the dry cleaning, and get the cake from the bakery?
And what will you be doing?
Sleeping in, of course. Can I let you know?
Are you going out with Leonard tonight?
Uh-huh. He's supposed to pick me up at 6:30. What time is it now?
5:45. You'd better get going.
You're kidding. I haven't even taken a shower.
Where are you going?
We haven't made up our minds yet. Maybe to a movie. Maybe to a party.
Go and see Forrest Gump. It's supposed to be interesting.
Oh, maybe we will. I've heard The Sixth Sense is good, too.
Well, personally, I prefer Forrest Gump. I really should be going. Do you want to go shopping tomorrow?
I'd like to go, but it depends. I might have to go to the store tomorrow and do some work. Can I let you know first thing in the morning?
Okay, that would be all right.
Ring, ring. Oh, there's the phone. It must be Leonard.
Well, I'll be going. Call me tomorrow.
I will. Have a good evening.
You too.
On the phone, a less formal call.
Good afternoon, Scott and Smith. May I help you?
May I speak to Mr. Scott or Mr. Smith, please?
I'm sorry. They aren't here right now. Who's calling, please?
George Martin.
Is there any message I can take, Mr. Martin?
No, I'll call back later.
Thank you for calling Scott and Smith.
A cup of coffee. Can I get you something to drink?
A cup of coffee, please.
With milk and sugar?
A little milk, but no sugar.
I never drink coffee at night.
Why not?
It keeps me awake.
What do you drink with supper?
Tea. It helps me relax.
I don't like tea.
There are so many kinds of tea. Maybe you should shop around and try to find one you like, because coffee is bad for you.
That's a good idea.
How about a drink? How about a drink tonight?
I'd love to.
Where can we meet?
How about the relax bar?
All right. What time?
Is 8 o'clock okay?
Yes, that's fine.
I will meet you there. I'm really looking forward to it.
Me too. I have a sore throat. You sound terrible.
I have a sore throat.
You should rest your voice.
I know. It hurts when I talk.
What are you taking for your throat?
Hot tea and honey.
That should help. Are you going to work today?
No, I'm staying home.
Good idea.
I'll feel better tomorrow.
I hope so. On sale.
Do you like my new coat?
It looks terrific.
I'm glad you like it.
How much was it?
$80.
That's a good price.
Yeah, it was on sale.
Where did you get it?
At Sears.
I'd like to shop there, too. They always have really good sales.
Maybe you should go there today. They have a sale on shirts if you're interested.
Good idea. I need some. Not a cloud in the sky. What a beautiful day.
Yes, there's not a cloud in the sky.
What's the temperature?
It's 70 degrees.
I love October.
Me too. It's not too hot and not too cold.
Fall is my favorite season.
Mine too.
The weather is almost perfect.
And the leaves are very pretty when they change colors.
Cold and windy.
Is it cold out?
Yes, it's cold and windy.
I'm going to wear my heavy coat.
Good idea. Where are you going?
To the post office.
Why?
To mail this package.
Would you buy some stamps for me?
Sure. How many do you want?
10. Here's the money for the stamps.
Okay. I'll be back in 20 minutes, unless I get blown away.
It's beginning to snow. Do you like snow?
No, I hate it.
Why? Snow is so pretty.
Yes, but I don't like to drive in it.
Well, it's beginning to snow.
And I have to drive to work.
How far is it to work?
6 miles. Are we going to get much snow?
About 12 inches, they say.
Oh, no. Driving will be dangerous. Please be careful.
I will. By the way, can I borrow your car? A house at the shore. When is your vacation?
It starts next week.
Where are you going?
We're renting a house on the shore.
That's wonderful.
Yes, we love the ocean.
Do you swim a lot?
Not very much.
Then why are you going to the shore?
Because we all bought new swimsuits.
A soccer game. I'm going to play soccer.
Who are you playing with?
Some friends from work.
Are you a good soccer player?
Yes, but I'm not the best player on the team.
What time does the game begin?
9 o'clock. Why don't you come with me?
I can't today. I'm very busy.
Okay. See you later.
I hope your team wins.
not so young. My son is graduating from high school today.
And my daughter is graduating next year.
How old is she?
She's 16.
I remember when she was a baby.
I know. We're getting old.
Don't say that.
Why not? It's true.
No, it isn't. We were young when we got married.
That's right, but we got married 25 years ago.
Is she single?
Today is my cousin's birthday.
What's your cousin's name?
Kathy. I'm going to her house after dinner.
How old is she?
She's 24.
She's my age. Is she pretty?
Yes, and she's very nice, too.
Is she single?
No, she's married and has two children.
Oh, that's too bad.
Not for her.
To buy a birthday present. What are you getting Jim for his birthday?
I don't know yet.
You can always get him a shirt.
But I got him one last year.
Oh, that's right. Let me think.
I want to get him something different.
How about a briefcase?
Good idea. His briefcase is getting old.
And it's something he'll use every day.
Of course. Why didn't I think of that?
Telephone. Hello?
Hello. Is Mary there?
I'm sorry. You have the wrong number.
Oh, is this 685-5290?
No, it's not.
I'm sorry.
That's okay. A light eater. Would you like anything else? You haven't eaten very much.
No, thanks. I'm already full.
Oh, come on. Have some more.
No, I really can't. I've never been much of an eater.
Have some coffee, then.
That would be nice.
How do you take it?
With sugar, please. No cream.
Here you are.
Thank you.
A nice flat. One. This is a nice flat. There's a living room, there's a kitchen, a bedroom, and a bathroom, and there's a bidet.
What's a bidet?
It's like a toilet, only better. I'll let you figure it out.
Well, none of my friends have a bidet, and even if I don't know what it is, they will be very jealous when I tell them.
A nice flat, two. Well, here's the kitchen.
It's very small.
Yes, it isn't very large, but there's a cooker and a fridge. There are some cupboards under the sink.
Are there any plates?
Yes, there are.
Good. Are there any chairs in here?
No, there aren't, but there are some in the living room.
There aren't any glasses.
Yes, there are. They're in the cupboard.
And where's the toilet?
Video designed by English7Levels.com.
Afraid of flying. Where is your meeting?
In Dallas, Texas.
How are you going?
By plane.
Do you like to fly?
Sure. It's fast and comfortable.
I'm afraid of flying.
That's silly. Flying is very safe.
Maybe, but I don't feel safe in a plane.
I understand. A lot of people feel that way.
A plane reservation. I'd like to reconfirm my plane reservation.
What flight are you taking?
Flight 207.
And your name, please?
Henry Chandler.
Yes, sir. You're booked on flight 207. Please check in at the airport an hour before flight time.
Thank you. Getting together. Are you free Friday night?
I might not be in town. I'm not sure yet. A friend suggested I go to Vancouver.
Well, a few of us are getting together, and I thought you might want to come too.
What are you thinking of doing?
We're not sure yet. We might go to a bar, but we'll probably go to see AI.
Oh, I haven't seen it yet.
Well, come then.
Sure. If I'm in town, I'll call you and let you know.
How's your new job going? Oh, Miss Wallace. Long time no see.
How are you?
Good, thank you. How's your new job?
I started working today.
How does it seem so far?
It's demanding, but I'm happy to be working.
What's your boss like?
He appears to be very thoughtful and kind, but they all do at first. I guess we will have to wait and see.
Well, I wish you the best of luck.
Thanks. Take care.
We eat a lot. Did you see my car keys?
They're on top of the TV.
You're right. Thanks.
Where are you going?
To the supermarket.
Again?
Yes, we eat a lot.
Do you want me to go with you?
Sure, if you can.
Good. The packages will be heavy.
There is a new health store right up the road. Maybe since you guys eat a lot, you should try and eat more healthily.
Maybe you're right. We have all put on a little weight.
I'll take you. Diana!
Oh, George. Hi, how are you? Listen, I'm in a terrible hurry. The bank closes in 20 minutes.
Is your bank near here?
Yes, it's only 4 blocks away, on Vine Street.
Well, get in. I'll take you.
Are you sure? It's not out of your way?
No, not at all.
That is so nice of you, George. Thank you.
You're welcome. We must be out of them. Hi. Sorry I'm late. I missed the bus.
Oh, that's okay. I had time to clean up before you came.
You don't look very good.
I must be getting a cold. I've been sneezing all day.
Bless you.
Thank you.
You must be getting a cold. Why don't you go lie down? I'll bring you some aspirin. I don't see any aspirin in the medicine cabinet.
We must be out of them.
I'll go to the drugstore. Is there anything else we need?
Could you get some...
I don't know if they...